Okay, start recording. You have to be dead silent, people. Because my wife is still sleeping. Don't wake up the sleeping dogs, right? Otherwise you get in trouble. So that video is just a quick one. I won't be able to do in spring break videos because I will be super busy. The week after I can do again a few videos. But what I want to show is this is Chromium. And here about Chromium. Version 73, I downgraded it, but I still have the same issue. And I know it's an old issue, it has been years ago, that like I work lots of with my calendar and I have to print it off, right? So if I go here to settings, then I go to print. And if I want to print it, let's say everything is normal, looks good to me. I press print and it opens up my file printer to PDF. And I have no chance to get to the real printer. Which is sad. But that's an old bug. Now it's back. And yeah, it causes some hassle to me. And I don't like it very much. But that's what we do. That's what we got. And I just thought I'd give you a hint. So if somebody has the old or the newer version from Chromium working and it prints just fine, let me know. Google doesn't have the problem. Firefox is a no-go. And just again for Firefox and Firefox things like WaterFox, and Basilisk, and as I said, they got themselves out of my life in the moment they made themselves incompatible with extensions from Firefox, like I used LastPass. However, if you look at this, I've got Google open, and you can't see it even. Firefox is always running on 25, 50%, even on an i7 CPU with 8 cores. That is super high. That is what is Firefox doing? Is it like Microsoft collecting your data and sending it over? It's just an open source here, just my thinking. I don't know, but I know that neither Google Chromium, Chromium or Google Chrome is taking any resources for hanging around idling with all the same sites open and web pages open, which I have usual open. So you can hardly see any interference with my CPU from either Chromium or Google Chrome. So for now, I need to have Google Chrome for printing my calendar and everything, which is okay. So anyway, Gmail, so they know about it. And Chromium in is then for all the other stuff. And that's totally fine by me. They're very easy on resources. And I like that a lot. So today, soon I have to go back because I changed my summer tires to my winter tires on my Prius, second generation. And they reprogrammed with the winter tires with the new sensors my computer. Now my computer can't reset the TPMS system. So now I have to pay money for it that they reprogrammed them, and I hope that's it. And then I got my TPMS system running again, which would be great. Okay, because I need it for road tests. Everything has to be in good order. And if I have a yellow light on, then they say, not safe to go. Even you can measure the pressure with your pressure gauge. But that's what people think, and that's always scary. So this is it. That's just a really short video about, I would say, resource usages from different browsers. All Firefox using, in my opinion, my experience, using tons of CPU power. And I wonder what they're doing. What is it using 50% of a CPU from an i5 or 8400 or from an i7 8-core CPU? That's lots of power usage. What for? Google Chrome doesn't do it. Chromium doesn't do it. Nothing should do it, right? Even simple screen recorders are easier on resources than Firefox. And they lost my trust when they injected code. So I don't know what they're doing, and I don't want to know. They're not running on my computer. And this is it. Once I lost my trust, it's gone, right? That's how it is. And I'm working on a different solution to set up a web interface for my emails. Like Squirrel or something. I put it on my Synology distations and I got access from there. And I can access it wherever I want, right? So I would be independent from Thunderbird because it's still back to Mozilla. They say they were off Mozilla, but they're too much Mozilla to me. And they want to go full Java, I think. And that is pretty bad. They want to go online, and online you have no control anymore what it's doing. You can't see the in and out traffic. And I don't like that. So, or I have to find a different client, which I like Claws, or I will see. I will have a look around. I will play around with it and see what it does. And then I go from there. Alright, so this is it, guys. I hope that a little video is somewhat informative. If you have the same trouble, do not worry or be wary. Everybody must have that problem, I trust, with Google Chromium, with Chromium now. Because Chromium cannot access my, not even my default printer, nothing, it just doesn't work. It always prints into PDF. So if you have that too, let me know, that would be good to know that I'm not the only one. And I hope that Chromium developers know about the old bug coming back. Okie dokie, this is it, guys. Stay safe, and it will take at least a whole week before I will be back online. I know, terrible word, but what can we do? Okay, guys, see ya. Bye-bye.